Remember profit, total revenue minus total cost? How do I figure out how much output yields the maximum amount of profit? Well, I remember total costs. And while I don't remember seeing total revenue before, I think we can figure it out. It's just price times quantity, right? And since price is always P star, let me say, for the moment, that P star is $5, if that's true, then for output equals zero, revenues equals zero. But if output equals 1, revenue is $5. An output of 2, revenue is $10, and so on. That means that for perfect competition, total revenue is just a straight line, increasing at each unit by the amount of the price. But what about profit? Remember that profit is the combined effect of total revenue and total cost. This still doesn't show profit directly, but it does give us the information needed to figure out what profit's going to look like. For example, at output levels Q1 and Q2, what's the profit? At both of these output levels, the total revenue is exactly equal to the total cost, so the profit's zero. What about output levels from 0 up to Q1? Because total cost is higher than total revenue at these levels of output, there are losses in this range. Do losses occur anywhere else? Look to the far right, beyond output level Q2. Again, total cost is greater than total revenue, so there are losses. This leaves us with output levels from Q1 to Q2. In this range, total revenue exceeds total cost, so profits are earned. Now that we have an idea what profit looks like at different levels of output, what level of output would you pick if this were your business? As a profit maximizer, you would want to pick the level that yields the highest profit. In this diagram, that would be output level Q star. How will I know that I have achieved this optimal level of output? Remember, at the maximum point, slope, or rise over run, or in this case, change in profit over change in quantity, has to be equal to zero. If I break this down a little, I'll get some terms that I recognize. For maximum profit, the firm owner chooses the level of output at which marginal revenue equals marginal cost. Marginal revenue equals marginal cost is always the profit maximizing rule. Think about it this way. What if marginal revenue is not equal to marginal cost? For example, what if marginal revenue is greater than marginal cost? This means that more is being added to revenue than to cost, so profits are still rising. You would want to increase your output until marginal revenue equals marginal cost. And what if marginal revenue is less than marginal cost? In this case, more is being added to cost than to revenue, so profits are falling. Notice this does not necessarily mean that profits are negative, just that profits have gone past the maximum and are now decreasing. In this case, you would want to cut back on your output until marginal revenue equals marginal cost. In the end, marginal revenue equals marginal cost is always the profit maximizing rule, no matter what the market structure. Next class, we'll do some problems using this profit maximizing rule.